In this video, I'll show you how to connect your USB drive to your Xbox Series S or X. I'll show you how to set up, and this way you'll be able to transfer content from your drive to the Xbox or record gameplay on it, transfer games and do other stuff with it. So let's get started. For this example, I'll use this small thumb drive, but again, you can use any other drive. First, make sure that it's formatted in NTFS. This is actually what Microsoft recommends here. If it's in another format, there is a good chance that it won't get recognized by the Xbox. So go ahead on your PC or even Mac and format it in NTFS before even starting to do what I'll show you next. Then when you're ready, just connect it on the front port here or in the back. It doesn't really matter. And once you connect it, well, now it appear here, but I'll show you how to get to this screen to have access to everything. So from the main menu over here, you're going to go into the settings. And once you're in settings, you're going to go down and select system. Whoops, system, and then select storage devices. And from here, you're gonna see your internal storage on the top and then the USB drive on the bottom. Now, if you do not see anything, wait a minute or two. The first time I connected mine, it took about 30 seconds to get recognized. Then, if nothing is appearing, again, make sure that it's the right format. Now, one important thing that is written here is that your USB drive needs to be at least 128 gigs or more and USB 3.0 or faster if you want to store game and apps on that drive. In my case, you see this small thumb drive is only 8 gigs, so if I go over it and click A, I won't get the option to be able to store games or apps. I will only be able to view the content. And this is great if you simply want to transfer pictures on your Xbox. Let's say you want to change your gamer pick with a custom one. Well, you can simply plug your USB drive. It doesn't have to be a very big one. And you can also set as capture location. This only means that you can actually screen record your gameplay on the drive itself and not on the hard drive of your Xbox. So as you see here, I only have these options. Now I have this drive that is 128 gigs and is not formatted in NTFS. And just check out what happens when I plug it in. I get this screen over here and it's simply asking me if I want to use this drive to transfer or to check music, videos and pictures that are on the drive itself, or do I want to use this drive to be able to transfer games and app. So the difference is if I want to use it as for media only, nothing will happen. If I want to use it for games, the Xbox will format my drive and I will lose everything that is on it. So this is something that you need to take account for. If this drive was already formatted NTFS, it won't ask me this detail over here. So just for this example, I'll set use for games and this will actually format the drive for me and I'll have to choose a new name, or I can just keep this one, I'll keep it. And select format storage device. I can simply select keep current location. And now I have to wait because the drive is getting formatted by the Xbox. Okay, so now I have my drive appearing right under here. By the way, if nothing happened during the 3 minutes, it didn't appear by itself, simply disconnect and connect it back. Sometimes I guess it's a bug. Anyway, so now we have our USB drive down below. If I press A, I'll get many more options compared to what we got with the smaller USB drive. So we have view contents, if you want to view whatever is on the USB drive. Then we have move and copy. This is if you want to move stuff from your drive to the internal drive. Okay, but right now my USB drive is empty. So if I click on it, I won't see anything. You see, because it's to transfer from this to this. And here there's nothing. And what other option do you have? You have uninstall content. If again, you had stuff installed on your drive, change how drive is configured. If you click on it, you can select this drive will stay attached to this console, or if you want to use it on multiple Xboxes, you can select this. You can rename your drive. You can format this drive again. or you can set as capture location. Now, if you want to transfer games on this, go back, go on internal storage, click A, select move and copy. And this time you'll be able to select games or apps you have over here. Let's say I want to move something over here. Let's say I want to move this one. You just have to select it with a check mark. Then you can select copy. So this way, whatever you select here will stay on the internal storage of your Xbox, but will also be on the USB drive. Or you can select move selected. This way it's completely gone on from your internal storage on the drive. And if I select here, I can select move, and here we go. It's now moving it. Perfect. It just took a few seconds because it was a very small file. Now, if we go back and I go on my USB drive, and if I go to move and copy, I'll see that I have this on it that we just transferred, and I can transfer it back. I select move, and here we go. It's back on my Xbox. So this is how you set up a USB drive, USB stick, or SSD on your Xbox Series X and S. I hope this was useful. If so, please leave a like, comment down below, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.